Hello everyone, today I will show you how to set up GA4 Ecommerce Tracking. As we know, when we connect Google Analytics with our website, then automatically Google Analytics collect basic data like how many people visit our site and where are they from. Like this data we can see in your analytics account. But if you want to track how many people visit the product page, click add to cart and check out, also purchase our product, then we need to set up e-commerce tracking. If we want to track and check how many people visit our website, product page visit means view item, and how many people click add to cart, then check out, also purchase our product. So we need to set up some tag here for tracking this kind of activity and visitor action. So how we can set up this tag trigger variable, in this tutorial I will show you very easily. So actually what we need, if you want to set up GA4 Ecommerce tracking, then you need to follow these 4 steps, then you can set up easily. Step 1, create a Google Analytics 4 account. Step 2, create a Google Tag Manager account. Step 3, connect Google Tag Manager to website, and then set up e-commerce tracking. If you don't know how to create Google Analytics account, Google Tag Manager account, also how to connect Google Tag Manager to website, then you can visit my YouTube channel, then you can watch this tutorial. I have already made video about it, how to create Google Analytics 4 account, how to create Tag Manager, and how to install Tag Manager on WordPress site. Also how to set up Google Analytics on WordPress using Google Tag Manager. So let's see how we can track e-commerce tracking. And then if I click here, then you can see how to set up. And final stage is you need to enable data layer. Also I have already made a video about it, how to enable data layer in WordPress site. If you watch this video, then you can easily enable data layer any WordPress website by using free plugin. Okay, let's see what we need to do. First we need to create trigger. In this video I show you 4 event tracking, like how many people visit product page. Product page mean view item, and then who click add to cart, I mean how many visitor click add to cart, then how many people click checkout or purchase. So if I go Google and search here GA4 recommend event, then we can get beautiful information here. If I open this tab, then we can see what kind of tag we need to set up and what is the trigger, also parameter name. So if I click purchase event name, and then we can see here Google Tag Manager option. We need to click here Google Tag Manager, and then we need to click purchase option. And if you click show the tag configuration, then we can see, okay, this is our purchase event configuration information. So see event name purchase, that means if you want to track how many people purchase from your website, this is purchase event. So you have to set up purchase event, and also you have to create some variable and pass some parameter like product item, product transaction ID, product value. So this kind of information you need to pass through event. So let's see how we can set up purchase event. So at first I want to save you time, that's why I think we should create trigger first. So I want to create new trigger. So if I click trigger option, then we can see screen like this, and just click new, click again, then we need to select custom event, and I want to set up 4 event like view item, add to cart, checkout and purchase. So basically first we need to create 4 trigger, then we need to create some variable, then final stage is we need to create some tag. Okay, let's see how we can create variable. So if I go here, at first I want to start with view item. So this is view item, and if I scroll down here, so we can see configuration setting. See, this is the view item tag. So you can copy this name for create trigger. It's very easy for you and you can save your time also. So copy this event name, go tag manager, paste this name and save it. You can write here your trigger name. So you need to write here your trigger name. I just write here GA4 view item trigger, and then we need to create one more trigger. We need checkout trigger. So I just find here checkout. Yeah, this is vegan checkout, right? Scroll down again and copy this event name. Again come GTM, paste this name and write here again trigger name GA4 checkout trigger. Okay, save. And final event is purchase event, right? Okay, just copy this event name, go GDM again and paste this event name. Write here your trigger name here. So I just write here GA4 purchase trigger. Okay, finally we're done create trigger. Now we need to create some variable. So if I go here, then you can see here is variable name and variable. So what actually we need just copy this e-commerce item. You have to select user defined variable. So click new and this is data layer variable. Select data layer variable. So you can write here our variable name e-commerce item, and then you can copy this e-commerce.item and paste here and just save. So we need this all variable name. I just do it fast for saving your time, so you can just watch. Okay, our variable create is done. So now we can create tag. This is the actually main thing you need to do. Okay, just click new and tag configuration, then select Google Analytics. Just select Google Analytics GA4 event, and we need to put here our measurement ID. So click here, and if you watch my previous videos, you know we are already create GA4 measurement constant variables. We can select this, and I need to write here event name. So if I go again this page, then first I want to set up purchase tag. So I just copy this name, event name, copy from here and paste here, and then we need to pass some parameter like this event parameter. Here is parameter name and this is the value. So okay, how, let's see how we can set up. So click here and click event parameter. I just add parameter. So let's see how many parameter we need to send. Here is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 7, right? So just click 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 and then copy from here, paste here, copy this, also this one. We have to send this parameter through our purchase event. Actually we need to send 7 parameter only for purchase event. Okay, so now we can just click here for item. So see, here is item, actually see, here is item parameter name and value is e-commerce item, right? So we are already make some variables, so we can select here e-commerce item. See, it's very easy. You can see this page, then you can set up easily. Click again, and this is we have to send transaction ID, right? So this is the e-commerce transaction ID and value, product value, purchase value. That means e-commerce value. This is the purchase value and text. Click e-commerce text and shipping. So we can just easily select from here. Where shipping? Yeah, this is. And currency means your product currency. Okay, and coupon, so you can select from here. This is the coupon. Okay, now we need to select here, choose our trigger, right? So click here and see, we are already made some trigger, so we can select purchase trigger because this is our purchase event. So and just click save, and you can write your tag name, event name. So I just write here my tag name, GA4 purchase tag. Okay, done. And now we need to make another tag. The tag name is checkout. So click again, click Google Tag Manager, select tag, and just select your G4 measurement ID. Just need to write here event name. So go again and select add to cart event, add to cart. This is add to cart, and scroll down. See, this is event name add to cart. So copy from here and write here, and see, you can see here how many parameter we need to pass. So you can see here is 3. So we can just copy from here and go event parameter, select add parameter. Actually, we need 3 parameter for add to cart event, right? So copy here item and value. Okay, also currency. Okay, so we can choose here our item, e-commerce item. So this is e-commerce item, this is e-commerce item. Also this one value, click currency, e-commerce.currency, and trigger choose, we have to select checkout. Okay, this is our add to cart event, right? So we need to select add to cart event and then save. Just write here your event name, add to cart tag, right? Okay, so save. So I just want to save your time, that's why I do it fast, so you can watch and understand easily. And for checkout event, we need to send 4 parameter. See, here is 4 parameter. So just add here 4 and copy item, paste here, copy this value, again paste, copy currency, also coupon. So and then we can easily select from here item, e-commerce item. This is e-commerce item and value. I think we already know that how to do that, right? Value, e-commerce value, currency, and coupon, trigger, checkout, right? Yeah, checkout is our trigger. Okay, again save, right here event name, and click save. Okay, we need one more event. The event name is view item. Yeah, event name is view item. So select event, select again G4 measurement ID and go here and just select, find out view item, see configuration, event name view item, copy from here and paste here again, and let's see how many event we need to send. Here is 3 events, so just click here, event parameter, click add parameter, we need three parameters, so just click here and copy from here item value and finally currency, right? So also you can write from here, see. Okay, so just select from here item e-commerce item value, so e-commerce value, this is value and currency. Yeah, where is currency? Yeah, e-commerce currency. And trigger is view item. Yeah, view item trigger. Click save and right here event name view item tag. Click save. Okay, so we are done. We are already create tag trigger variable. So now time is check our tag perfectly work or not. So we need to go preview mode, then we can easily check every tag perfectly work or not. So click connect, our assistant is connected. So see here, you know any tag fire view item. So if I go product page, then we can see, yeah, then we can see view item tag already fired here. See, if I click variable, then you can see our variable item product value is 100. So this product is $100. So you can see, and also you can check Google Analytics debug mode. So let's see how we can see from your Google Analytics. Just go your analytics dashboard, click admin and scroll down. Then you can see here is option, another option. So option is debug mode, yeah, debug view. So if I click here, then we can see live from our Google Analytics. See, I visit this page, that's why here show view item. So if I click here, then you can see product value, page title, everything you can see from here, currency, USD. So if I click add to cart, then you can see from GTM here fire add to cart event, also GTM you can see here is add to cart event. Sometime here take some moment for coming event. Okay, so let's see. So if I click checkout, see here is already checkout event fire. Yeah, this is our checkout event. See, checkout event fire here. And also if I go analytics, then we can see here is another event fire. Event name is checkout. I think we should wait here some moment. Okay, let's purchase this product. If I fill up this form, see here I already fill up this checkout page. And now if I click place order, so we need to select billing district, right? So I select from here, wait, district is see, we have already ordered this product. And if I go again tag manager, then you can see here already fire purchase tag. And if I click here and then variable, we can see product item here is three product I order from this site. And then we can see transaction ID, this is transaction ID, and this is value, product value. See, here is 262, here is total value 262. And now we can check also from our analytics. So yeah, we are successful set up our e-commerce tracking through Google Tag Manager. I hope you can set up easily through watching this tutorial video. Maybe it will help you, and if you need any help, you can reach out to me. Definitely I will help you. Thank you for watching this video.